What an incredible discovery. Who would have guessed that a plant phytosterol could have such a tremendously powerful effect on reducing anxiety, i.e. at least in an animal model. But the researchers don't have any reason to believe that this will not translate into humans when human clinical trials are done in reference to beta-sitosterol. Now, a lot of people may recognize the name beta-sitosterol in reference to a common nutraceutical found on shelves, either in reference to cholesterol or prostate issues. But however, through a very, very detailed genomic scavenger hunt, so to say, researchers came along this particular phytosterol that met the perfect profile to reducing anxiety, yet not leaving the side effects normally associated with anti-anxiety medication. Again, the caveat being this is to be carried out to human trials. However, just the same, this is fascinating. So let us begin right with the research as follows. A natural food supplement may relieve anxiety, studies suggest. A natural food supplement reduces anxiety in mice, remember it's an animal model, according to a new Weizmann Institute of Science study. The plant-derived substance, beta-sitosterol, or cytosterol, was found to produce this effect both on its own and in synergistic combination with an antidepressant, normally known as Prozac. If these findings published today in Cell Reports Medicine are confirmed in clinical trials, they could point the way toward the use of beta-sitosterol as a treatment for relieving anxiety in humans. To proceed. Now keep in mind, the interesting aspect as we review the study more, beta-sitosterol worked well on its own, but at the same time too, they found, at least in the animal model, they were able to reduce the dosaging down on the Prozac or fluoxetine into such a way to reduce a lot of the side effects or unintended consequences of that medication as well. So keep in mind, this is a dual study. One, reducing the dosaging required on antidepressants while relieving anxiety, and two, as a standalone to take beta-sitosterol on its own. Proceed. Anxiety is not always a bad thing. In fact, in evolutionary terms, feeling anxious about potential threats is critical for survival because it helps us mount an appropriate response. That's precisely why developing anti-anxiety drugs, or in this case food, is so challenging. The circuits for anxiety in the brain are closely related to those responsible for memory. Here's the catch. Awareness and other functions vital for handling danger. So scientists are on the lookout for compounds that could selectively suppress anxiety without causing those unwanted side effects. And they looked at a plethora of phytosterols. And keep in mind, they realized a lot of the studies in reference to phytosterols had mixed results until they focused just on the one. Now proceed ahead. In this new study, I don't want to mispronounce the name, I believe it's Fanzibler's lab, together with colleagues, searched for an international genomic database for existing drugs or other compounds. So look at drugs, compounds, everything that mimic the same gene expression signature that they're looking for. Something to relieve anxiety, reduce anxiety, without having any of those unwanted effects, unnecessarily those evolutionary, cues to proceed. They identified, or he identified, five candidates and tested their effects on behavior in mice. That's how the researchers zeroed in on beta-sitosterol, a plant substance sold as a dietary supplement intended mainly to reduce cholesterol, quote-unquote, to proceed forward. Moreover, the mice receiving beta-sitosterol did not exhibit any of the side effects that might be expected from anti-anxiety medications. The locomotion was not impaired, and they did not refrain from exploring novel stimuli. So they were able to continue, as mice do, I suppose, in their daily activities without feeling sedated, suppressed, or unaware, or having their awareness of the situational surroundings reduced down while maintaining curiosity about their surroundings. But to proceed. Next, the researchers tested the effects of beta-sitosterol on mice when given a combination with fluoxetine, a drug belonging to a class of selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors, or SSRIs, and sold in the brand name Prozac, among others. The combination had a synergistic effect. Both beta-sitosterol and fluoxetine reduced the anxiety of mice at a lower dosage when given together. As you go to the full study, I mean, they really used low dosage and it had a very powerful effect working together. Again, beta-cetosterol could work well on its own, but in combination, again, always consult a medical professional before venturing forward, but in combination, at least in the animal model, they were able to reduce the amount of fluoxetine down quite substantially, yet achieve that antidepressant anti-anxiety effect without the side effects, as much side effects, I should say. Compare with the doses needed to produce the same effect when they were administered separately. Quote, one of the major problems with existing anti-anxiety medications is that they produce side effects, so if beta-cetosterol can help cut down the dosage of such medications, it might potentially also reduce the unwanted side effects, quote unquote, the wonderful researcher whose name I probably cannot pronounce. Now, we're going to go to the full study for the conclusion. Then after we read the conclusion, we'll look at the details referenced to the dosaging that you utilized in both the fluoxetine and beta-cetosterol on its own. But to proceed, these findings suggest that beta-cetosterol can be repositioned as an anxiolytic, either as a standalone anti-anxiety medication, therapeutic, or in synergistic combination with SSRI class drugs such as fluoxetine. Remember, we need human trials in order to confirm exactly how that works. An animal model is wonderful and it's great, but however though, obviously the biology is different. However though, at the same time too, two howevers, I guess one caveat, would be basically that the research don't anticipate it operating any differently in the animal model to the human model. But guessing and studying are two different things. But to proceed. So we look at basically the research as follows, to put up here, and I'll follow along with you. You can see, right, for example, how they picked out the beta-cetosterol right there, if you look at the chart. But also, too, as a dosaging. This is the dosage that they used in the animal model. So if you look at, so let's see, they had the tremendous effect on the beta-cetosterol on its own at 100 milligrams a kilogram, at least in this study. And I believe in this case, it was administered oral gavage, so basically down the throat, but still to mimic, so to say, normal digestion, but in a way that they could actually monitor the amount given, as opposed to just having it in its food and ad lib. Illibidum, something like that. But however, though, just the same, there's the dosages that they utilized between 20, 50, 75, and 100 milligrams. And they found out, ironically, it may have been dose dependent, at 100 milligrams a kilogram in the animal model, they had wonderful, wonderful, wonderful anti-anxiety type effects, at least the standalone, in reference to the beta-cetosterol on its own. Wonderfully, beautifully, well-done study, eloquent, and the fact that nature has solutions to many of the issues that face us today, it's just a matter of finding them. They searched through this giant genomic database, and ironically, as opposed to finding a drug or some of the chemical compound, they found something that occurred naturally in avocados, for example. Now, albeit, you'd have to eat a ton of avocados to get the same dosaging effect, but still just the same, it is a start, it is safe, it is wonderful, and maybe consulting medical professionals in the studies in the future could be in conjunction with other elements in order to reduce that dosaging down, therefore reduce the unwanted side effects that can often be accompanied by dosaging in those medications. Or if they don't work well on their own, maybe with a consulting medical professional, that beta-cetosterol in combination, who knows, they have a wonderful, wonderful effect. And at least at this point in time, it appears to be incredibly, incredibly safe, and ironically, may yield side benefits as opposed to side effects. Again, Ralph Tricciano signing off. Gratitude first to the researchers for conducting research such as this, which basically empowers and strengthens our lives. Gratitude to you for listening. We look forward to see you all once again next week. As always, thank you, gratitude, humbly, and always appreciate you watching. I'll catch you next time. See you then. Bye.